friends, I am back with our session 2 of Facebook. Last session we had an introductory session about IELTS Speaking Part 1. This Friday it is all about IELTS Speaking Part 2, which is about cue cards. Now before I proceed in detail, let me just give you a briefing about what is included in IELTS Speaking Part 2. Basically, you are given a cue card. Now, what's a cue card? It is a topic. It could be from any particular area which we would be discussing here. You are given a topic on a sheet of paper. You have 3 sub-points that are given beneath that topic to give you an idea about what you can speak about on that particular topic. Once you are given that topic, you are given a blank paper and a pencil to note down your bullet points. The 1 minute that is allotted to you, you need to use it very minutely and carefully to note down all the key areas that you would be including. Once you are done with your minute, you have to speak on the same topic for 1 to 2 minutes. So this is what Section 2 IELTS Speaking is all about. You have to speak on a particular topic that is given to you. You are given 1 minute for the preparation, and then you need to present on the same particular topic for 1 to 2 minutes. Now, let's start about some four key areas which you should always keep in mind before you start the preparation of your cue cards. First, it is very important to read the topic very, very carefully. The thing is that we only have 1 minute, and generally we just read the keyword and start speaking about the topic. We do not concentrate on what the full topic is about. Are you asked about a past experience? Are you asked about what do you wish to do in future? Are you asked about a trip that you have already been to? Or they are asking you about a trip you want to go in future? Right? So the trip is the common word here. That is your main subject. But you might fall in the trap if you do not understand the crux. At times, we might describe about what is not asked. You may go vice versa. So it is very important for you to read the topic very, very carefully. Do not just focus on the keyword like letter or object or trip. Focus on the entire topic. Second, use your 1 minute very, very wisely. The 1 minute that is given to you is actually your preparation time, wherein you have to make all the key points. Now, what key points are? The key points are what you are going to include in your speaking. See, it is not possible for each and every student to keep thinking and also speaking. So for those students, it is always a great idea to make some pointers. You can have, say, 7 to 8 bullet points, and then just speak on those bullet points which you have written. So always use your time wisely by making your bullet points, which is my next area, that is the bullet points. Now, you know what? You can take help from the pointers that are provided to you. You have the topic, and beneath the topic, there are always 3 pointers that you will find in your IELTS examination. Now make sure it is not necessary. You will not be penalized if you do not include all the 3 pointers. Those 3 pointers are only given to you to take help from. So it is absolutely not necessary to include all the 3 pointers, but make sure you take help from them. Okay, so these were four key areas, or these are four key tips that you always need to remember when you are starting the preparation of your cue cards. Read your topic carefully, use the 1 minute very, very wisely. Even you can practice this way. Give yourself a topic, give yourself a minute, note down as many pointers you can and start speaking, making your bullet points, and finally the pointers that are provided to you, you can take help from them. Now let's proceed further and discuss in detail about what needs to be included in your cue cards. Now, do you remember in our last class we discussed about the power of W's and 8's? I think you remember because we had a detailed discussion about all the W's and 8's. See, W's, when, where, why, what, with whom, how. So these are some bullets. Remember, I just asked you to make some bullet points. So answering these questions will help you to make approximately 7 to 8 bullet points that you can use in your speaking. Say for example, if your topic is a cafe that you visited. So when did you visit that cafe? Where? What is the location of that cafe? Why did you visit that cafe? Probably it was your friend's birthday, you threw a party, it was a celebration. So the reason, why did you visit the cafe? What was the occasion about? So you can club these two areas. With whom? You visited with your friends, with your family, your office colleagues. Who? How? How did you go there? Public transport? You used your own vehicle? So basically these are the areas which you can include in your cue card. So whenever you have that one important minute, make sure you make such pointers, and the power of W's and 8's will always help you to speak fluently for 1 to 2 minutes. Now let me tell you how you need to divide your time. First 10 to 15 seconds. First impression is the last impression. First 3 to 5 statements that you speak, which longs for 10 to 15 seconds, are really important. Because the way you start your cue card topics boosts your confidence. So make sure that you give a very good start to your cue card topic. Now there are two ways how you can start your cue card topics. The first way, and this is a very, very common way, let me tell you. Children usually start their cue card topic with, the topic provided to me is, or I will be speaking about, the topic given to me is. So this is a very common way of starting your cue card topic, which is absolutely correct. So in order to avoid any error, any mistake, you can start your topic this way, that the topic provided to me is a cafe that you visited and I would like to describe about it. Right? Then, it is always good to give a very small introduction to your object. Now, what is an object? So, let us discuss how to identify the object in your cue cards. Okay, now if the topic is describe an important letter that you received, describe a cafe you visited. Moving further, describe a book you enjoyed reading. And Now look at some areas here. I have marked them for you. Letter, cafe, book. What are these? These are the main objects. What you need to do is, in the first 10 to 15 seconds, you can always elaborate these objects. But it is very important for you to first identify what the objects are. In the first case, object is letter. In the second cue card, it is cafe. And in the third one, it is a book. Now, how can you define a letter? So you can start as, letters have become very common nowadays. Or you can start as, letters have been very common since past time, although nowadays emails have taken place of letters. Here I would like to describe about an important letter that I received, right? So in the first 15 seconds we gave introduction to the letter. Similarly, for cafe it could be something like, cafe culture is quite common nowadays. We see various cafes in every nook and corner nowadays. Here I would like to describe about one cafe which is near my house, or I would like to describe about a cafe which I visited recently. Then book. I like reading books. I have read many books. As a child, I enjoyed reading fiction books, and as an adult, I enjoy reading all kind of books. Here, I would like to describe about a book which I enjoyed reading when I was in 11th grade, right? So these are the kind of introductions which you can give while in your initial 20 seconds. Now, why did I ask you to give this introduction? Because these introductions would always give a good start to your cue card. You know, there is something like task achievement, whether you have understood the cue card or not. So if you give an introduction to this part, the examiner will have this notion that yes, you have understood what the topic is and you know what to describe about. So it is always a good idea to describe what you would be including in your cue card. This same approach we will also be following in our essay. So in our next sessions, which would be related to essay writing, you would see a similar approach. Now, once you are done with these introductory part, then you will be including all the power of W's and 8's, as I said. After giving the introduction, say for example, if it is a letter, identify what category is it. Is it a formal letter? Is it an informal letter? Is it an official letter? Was it a personal letter? Academic letter? What category of letter was it? Who gave you the letter? What was the letter all about? What was written in the letter? Do you still have that letter? When did you last read that letter? If it is a personal one, right? So always make these pointers and then proceed further. If it is about a cafe, there are very many areas that you can include. After giving a small introduction for 15 to 20 seconds, why, when, where, with whom, what did you have there, how was your experience, how was the ambiance of the place, what did you like the most, anything you disliked about the place, even you can include that. So make sure that you speak for a minimum of 1 minute and you can go till 2 minutes. Don't worry if you exceed the time limit, because the examiner will stop you. Something that is really important is, if the examiner stops you between 1 to 2 minutes, don't worry, it is absolutely fine. Probably you are going good, the person is satisfied, knows you are good and wants to proceed with the next part. So don't panic. Very, very important. Don't go upon the expression of the examiner. Some are expressive, some are not. So don't think that what is going on in an examiner's mind. You should be confident, have a perfect body language and perfect fluency. You have been practicing for very long, so just give your best shot in the examination, right? So today's session was all about cue cards. What should be your approach? How should you start? What are the things that you need to include? What are the areas that are very important? And how would you end a cue card? How would you end a cue card? Would you have a conclusion? Now, conclusion is something that is totally up to you. If the topic is such, say for example, if it is a cafe, how can you end? Well, it was a wonderful experience. I especially loved the food and the music, the live music was quite lovely. I enjoyed listening to it. Given an option, I would want to visit this place again with my parents. They would love to have such an experience, right? This is how you can end a description of a cafe. Now, if it is a book you enjoy reading. So, you started with the introduction. You described everything about the book. How you can end? You can end as, it was a great experience reading this book. Every time I read this book, I learn something new out of it. There are many friends of mine who love reading. This is a kind of book I would like to suggest for people who are more into non-fiction reading, right? So this is how you can end. So conclusion in a way that your topic looks absolutely complete. But very important, make sure all these pointer needs to be included in 2 minutes. Do not go too lengthy. Do not be too precise. You have to practice a lot for this. If you have gone through my sessions before, I have discussed some tactics here. We had a prop game. I asked you to do mirror practice. I asked you to record yourself. How many of you are actually doing it? Do message me in the comment section. Because these are 3 important tests which always will help you to score good. If some new people have joined us, let me tell you what a prop game is. Pick anything, say for example a pen, and start describing about that object. See whether you can describe an object for more than 1 minute or not. So it would enhance your spontaneity. You would be more spontaneous. The second game is mirror practice. Sit in front of the mirror, stand in front of the mirror, face yourself, look into your eyes. Definitely it will help you boost your confidence, right? So these are the type of games. And finally, you can record yourself. See, we speak and we forget, but if we have a recording, we would be able to improve upon it. So make sure whenever you speak on a cue card, you record your voice, you listen to it again, and you learn from it, right? So I hope you enjoyed today's session. You learned a lot from it. If you want to learn more, we have our YouTube channel. Do subscribe to it and get any new video that is new. Next session, we would be here soon. We would be posting about our next session. And have a great weekend, guys. It's bye-bye from Poorvi from Rao Consultants.